Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be giving you a brief introduction of what is NFT and how does it work. So let's get started. Well, NFT stands for non-fungible token. This full form itself has two parts to it. One being non-fungible and other being token. Here, by non-fungible, we mean that it's unique in its nature. Unlike something that is fungible like Bitcoin or Ethereum, a perfect example of a non-fungible item would be Mona Lisa painting. And by token, we refer to its digital existence and the fact that it is protected using blockchain technology. To break it down even further, we can state simply that an NFT is just a digital asset that, because of its existence on a blockchain, can't be replicated. Further, the most common example of NFTs today is digital artwork, but it could be a whole lot of other things as well, like GIFs, songs, videos, tweets, digital skins for games, or even digital counterparts of a real painting. And the best part about this is the fact that you are recorded as the owner of that product in the blockchain, which is more secure than any of the physical counterparts. Lastly, a few well-known examples of NFTs include Bored Ape Yacht Club, CryptoPunk, and Axie Infinity. Next, you've got a fair understanding of what is NFT now. Let's discuss how does NFTs work. To put it simply, an NFT relies on two pieces of technology, blockchain and cryptocurrencies. Blockchain, as we all know, is a distributed digital ledger, or in other words, a shared electronic database. And you need cryptocurrencies to buy NFTs. The most common one used here is called Ether, which uses the Ethereum blockchain. However, there are other digital currencies on different blockchains that can be used as well, depending on where you plan to purchase your NFT or what is your operating platform. Now, let's try to understand the working of NFTs here. By spending your Ether on an NFT, your purchase is added to the blockchain. And because no one else can change this, there is a clear piece of proof that you own the NFT in what we call as a smart contract, which is another piece of data that shows ownership, how is it being transferred, license fees, and other key pieces of information. If you'd like to learn more about smart contracts, I'll recommend you to watch this video. Link for the same is given in the description below. So, you've got some Ether or any other cryptocurrencies for NFTs, let's say. And now you're asking yourself, where should I go to make a purchase? Or where to buy NFTs? Well, to be honest, there are only a handful of legitimate places where you can go and make a purchase without being ripped off. And a few that I can recommend include OpenSea, Rarible, Binance NFT, and Super Rare. If you ask me, my personal favorite of all of them is OpenSea. Also, it's worth noting that as with physical art, an NFT is only worth as much as its perceived value, which can change dramatically with respect to the market conditions, of course. So if you're buying an NFT today for $1,000, it may not be worth that much tomorrow. And while there might be gains, there's also a possibility of making losses. Now I'll be answering a few of the most asked questions in the NFT space to help you grab the concept with ease. Starting with the biggest one, are NFTs a scam? Well, while the core concept of NFTs isn't a scam and the large majority are very much legit, that doesn't mean that they are all safe. By safe, I mean the worth that they claim on the marketplaces like OpenSea. The technology behind NFTs is new and somewhat complicated, and there are people looking to capitalize on this confusion. So before investing, it's always better to do your own research and find about the vision of the project and maybe even join the Discord channel to see what other people are saying about it. Next, does an NFT grant copyright ownership? So sorry to break your heart, but when you purchase an NFT, you might not be buying the complete ownership of that product. Yes, you do become the owner in the sense that it is now your property and the ownership is traceable on the blockchain, but that isn't always accompanied by the laws of copyright in your country. This means you might not have permission to reproduce it. For example, putting it on a t-shirt. Next, are NFTs bad for environment? Now, this is a little harsh one. And to be honest, a large number of NFTs carry a pretty huge carbon footprint. To talk about Ethereum alone, it uses more energy than the Netherlands, which is over 100 terawatt hour per year. So yes, NFTs are causing harm to the environment. But Ethereum is working to solve this. How? As we all know that proof of work and proof of stake are the two ways a blockchain transaction can be verified. And while proof of work is an older and more energy intensive version, proof of stake is newer and less energy intensive, and is the option most cryptocurrencies are moving to, including Ethereum, with the launch of Ethereum 2.0. Next, what can an NFT be used for and what is the future? Right now, most of the examples we see on the internet are art NFTs. These can be pictures, illustrations, GIFs, or other pieces of art people have created, but that isn't the only form an NFT could take. To be honest, the power of NFTs is the authentication. In the traditional world, we use all kind of intermediaries to authenticate any form of information or transaction. Whether you are an artist trying to get authentication that your work is the original, or bank making a payment, or even a marriage license. All these situations need a third party to declare their authenticity. And if you think about it, everything in our economy that is transaction-based can be linked with an equivalent use case. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.